Hello and welcome to the Machinist News Network. I'm Deirdre Kanievsky. Unfortunately, too many workers know firsthand the hardships of corporate bankruptcy. Those on the front lines usually get hurt the most. That's why Congress is trying to pass a new bankruptcy bill.
This time they refused to fund our pension plans, ultimately terminating them. I had counted on retiring with a pension from United in the neighborhood of $3,000 a month. After United shifted its pension obligations onto the Pension Benefit Guarantee Corporation, I will only get around $750 a month from the PBGC.
After nearly two decades with United Airlines, this is what Richard Pascarella has to look forward to in his golden years. His story is one of millions.
I don't understand how you can put an airline into bankruptcy or a company into bankruptcy and get a bonus for doing so, a bonus to fail.
Businesses have used it as a backdoor way to slash wages and benefits for current workers and break promises to retirees.
That's why, in a bipartisan effort, Congress is putting forth new bankruptcy legislation to protect workers like Richard.
But this is about fairness and something all Americans understand.
This bill tries to level the playing field. Not only does it increase workers' claims during a corporate bankruptcy, but it also reduces what workers have to give up. It stops companies from using Chapter 11 as a way to get out of its labor agreements and helps to close the gap between the frontline workers and those in the executive suites.
No longer will executives and insiders be able to pay themselves huge bonuses in the midst of slashing payroll and benefits for workers and retirees. No longer will consultants receive huge fees while retirees are walking away from their pensions. And no longer will companies be able to sell off all the assets that make the company worthwhile and refuse to use the proceeds to support the workers who gave their lives to the company and now have lost their livelihoods.
The idea is simple. If workers have to sacrifice their wages and benefits because of a bankruptcy, so too should those who run the company.
Corporate bankruptcies should not be viewed as convenient methods for companies to undo the mistakes of their executives on the backs of their workers, because that's what happens all the time.
No one ever wants a bankruptcy to happen, but if it does, workers just want to know that they are going to be treated fairly. Right now, this bill is moving through Congress with that intent. For more Machinist News, you can log on to goiam.org. Thanks for watching.